Where do we start?
And where did we start?
Oh man, me and Johnny met way back in the day. We went to elementary school together at Grevenau Elementary School. I used to beat him up, took his lunch money. We went to junior high together. We went to high school together. And then we went to college together. We roomed together for 2 years. And it was fun. I hated him. I can you hit off, you little jerk. By the way, today's documentary is brought to you by Quaker Oats Rice Cakes. This one particular flavor is apple cinnamon. It's like eating styrofoam, just with less flavor.
Very little. And Ryan, Peter?
It's not, well, not to you yet. Okay. So we roomed together for 2 years. And yeah, we had our share of fights. And well, when weren't we fighting, you know?
Shut up, I mean it. We got together one day, and I had just started playing guitar, and Ryan only knew one chord. So we kind of strung through some stuff and wrote a few songs. It sounded pretty bad. Then we started working at some more repertoire, which is a French word, by the way, repertoire. And realized it wasn't half bad, dang on it. It wasn't half bad. And we decided to form a group called
Nature's Pavilion.
Yes.
But
that didn't work out.
Didn't really have any idea what that was about.
It's true. We actually never had one show under that name.
We did birthday parties, mainly.
So I discovered the Lonely Ninjas in Kenosha, Wisconsin, at the local rec center. I was there for my niece's 12-year-old birthday party. They played their set in between, you know, the cutting of the cake and the pin the tail on the donkey. And I knew from those two songs. I knew. I mean, hit me deep. Struck the core of my being. I mean, they were splendoricious. I knew then what everyone else is saying now. You know, they have it. They have it. I've seen some bands, you know. You're gonna want a manager. You're gonna want someone to protect you. You just, you know, scrape the tip of the iceberg right now. The sky's the limit. What can we be doing? Bar mitzvahs, funerals, high school graduations? I mean, come on!
And while at one birthday party, we met a guy named
Dave Scott,
who changed our life.
I had him sign the contract, you know, sign the life away. I mean, just normal party A, party B stuff, you know? And now we're a team, you know? I protect them, they protect me, my interest may be financial, sure, you know? I make gold records, you know? That's what I do. But, you know, I love these guys.
Well, he pretty much said this and this alone. I love you guys. You guys rock. We need you to become a band that unites and presents sunshine to the crowd.
He said, what I hear now is almost music.
That's what we call ourselves, pretty much. Our kind of music was almost music.
He said, I want to take you to the next step, which is pretty darn close to music.
I can remember the first time that my manager, Adam, gave me a call and said that his buddy Dave, who's pretty big in the upper mid for talent scouting, and found this new group called the Lonely Ninjas, and wanted to know if I needed an opening act for my tour. And to be honest, the first time that I kind of heard about it, I was a little skeptical. And then, you know, Adam said that he and Dave were pretty good friends, so you know, I should just kind of go with it. And then, you know, went into the studio to meet them, and I wasn't really impressed at first.
Before we got big, before we were doing bar mitzvahs, before we were doing shows at the Encore,
before we were doing funerals,
before we were opening for Ben Hacker,
oh,
we needed a bass player.
And he said we couldn't find, we looked everywhere. But then, sitting in the corner of his room one day when we were walking through the dorms, we saw this kid in the corner of his room.
Just sitting, staring out the window.
His name's Peter. Probably one of the better bass players I've ever heard.
Thanks, Ryan. I appreciate it. You mean it?
I do mean that. I'm not just saying that because we're rolling right now. So.
Thank you.
No, we're here for you. Great. Anyway, Peter's been a great asset to the force. He's now part of the Lonely Ninjas, which is what we changed our name to, since we figured it made a little bit more sense than Nature's Pavilion, but not much more.
Ryan and John, what can I say? As head cook for them on the road, I know they're sure not good musicians, but they sure do love their cat. Nice and crispy.
Can I get you guys a soda or something?
Okay.
Diet Coke.
Why don't you do that?
I'm good.
Diet Coke?
Diet Coke would be good.
Okay.
Listen, we just felt bad for him. We, he was sitting in his room looking out his window, but all that sits outside his window is a wall. He doesn't have a window. So anyway,
Peter's... like having him as an asset to the group, and I think...
Big asset to the group, thank you.
I think we just got our lucky stars.
They opened for me for a couple of my shows, and you know, it went all right, and I'm glad to see that they're having some success now.
What's up, everybody? I'm Banzai.
I'm Mad Dog.
Tiger Claw.
And we are the Lonely Ninja Bodyguards.
Holla, holla.
So, being a Lonely Ninja Bodyguard isn't real difficult because they aren't that popular yet, and they haven't done that many shows. But yesterday, we ran into a little bit of a problem at the retirement home.
Yeah, I think they ran out of applesauce. They went nuts.
And apparently some of the patients can't take their medicine without the applesauce. So what we had was a lot of elderly people, really rowdy. I mean, there's body surfing and just things that 80-year-old people shouldn't be doing. Well, Granny Smith was body surfing, and apparently someone dropped her. She broke a hip. Tiger Claw here had to do CPR. But, I mean, that's all... It's all in the job of a bodyguard.
Mm-hmm. Oh, at one point in time, we were opening for Ben Hacker, my friends, and now...
At this concert that we were at, he opened for us.
He opened for us.
Well, I really wouldn't say that I'm opening for them. I think one of the main reasons that I'm on the ticket is so that people will come.
So they're playing at a church for a funeral, and we had a few problems there. Apparently... The Lonely Ninjas didn't know that you weren't supposed to take the deceased and throw them out to body surf.
Yeah, those people, they're getting in my face. And I don't like when people get in my face.
Tiger Claw!
And apparently Tiger Claw over here didn't know that the baptismal font was just for baptisms. And really, it's kind of disrespectful. So, but it's all in a day's work for the bodyguards of the Lonely Ninjas.
I would describe our sound kind of
emo.
In indie rock, emo, pop,
punk,
kind jazz, of. Rap, punk,
hip hop,
ska,
a little bit of ska,
jazz, hard rock, alternative,
yeah. Right, a little bit of classical.
They really kind of pull from a lot of different things. Bob Dylan meets Metallica is one of the things that comes to my mind. So I think that, yeah, that's how I'd have to describe them. Definitely, I think a little bit of Bernadette Lady sprinkled on the top.
But overall, I think we're kind of the blue man without the blue.
Without the blue.
Without the blue. Or the percussion.
See, we have something right here, my friends. A lot of people don't. And I'm not talking about
the left pectoral.
No. I'm talking about the heart.
Heart.
We have the heart.
See, we like to bring sunshine to you guys. Sunshine.
Sometimes raindrops and cloudy days too.
On your shoulders. Makes you happy.
And if we fail, it's a boo.
Finest little girl on the side of Mississippi. Ain't no pity that Cupid's arrow hit me. I'll tell the whole city the love bug you bit me. I'll grab my disc and play a little frisbee. High on love and I'm feeling pretty tipsy. I'll grab my chips and dip it in a dipping. Take a bite and share with my pretty nifty hippie. Yippin' skippin', she's the fly zippin'. Finest little girl on the side of the Mississippi. Ain't no pity the Cupid's arrow hit me. I'll tell the whole city the love bug you bit me. I'll grab my disc and play a little frisbee. Feeling pretty tipsy. I'll grab my chip and dip it in the dipping. Take a bite and share with my pretty nifty hippie.
I just came out with a new album. It's called The Ben Hacker Project, and just really encompasses a lot of, you know, where I grew up and how I grew up and things that I've been through. And this next song was just kind of a story from my childhood called City Girl.
You never climbed up.
hooks on you, you won't be able to dodge the bullet this time. You blink and it's over.
This song is called Close Your Eyes. Close your eyes and lay your head down.
Think of fluffy things like linen and clowns.
Tuck yourself in tight.
We'll be here all night.
So
close your eyes and lay your head down.
The stars in the sky will shine down tonight
as we sing you this lullaby.
The fireflies too
will glow just for you,
and the moon
will light up your eyes.
Close your eyes and drift off to sleep.
Quiet, you won't make a peep.
Not a peep. So don't scream and run.
Or call 911.
Just
close your eyes and drift off to sleep.
We don't mean to scare by the way that we stare.
We just like to watch you dream.
Tight
and it covers tight, just right.
It's enough
to make us both gleam.
You dream real pretty, like. And when the sun and moon trade places,
you wake up seeing our gentle, sweet faces.
And when our song's sung,
our job will be done,
and you'll
be lost in our embraces.
Close your eyes, pretend we're not here.
And if we collect your hair, and cause we care, my dear,
we do. We'll build you a shrine,
be here all the time.
So
close your eyes, pretend we're not here.
My